Let's quickly go over the custom installation here. Now we're looking at the touchscreen of the eCinema player. Now this is developed by my company, so I've actually evolved it to be more applicable to these installations. So this is a typical eCinema player where you can load content and like a DCI player, but it's for eCinema files. But we're more interested in the automation aspect of it and how the automation has grown over the years to be more complex but also easy to use. So in here we've got different controls. So you've got the projector controls here. I can turn the lamp on and off, the projector on and off, the dowser on and off. I can change the input to any input I want on the projector. And I've also got a 4x2 matrix switcher. So at the moment it's the preview screen there and the projector. The preview is looking at the Blu-ray, or I can go to the satellite box by clicking that. And you'll see up there quickly, there's the TV box there. And if, as you know, I can pretty much, if I wanted to go out to the projector too, I push that and that image would be on the projector as well. Same with the Blu-ray. This is very good for the Blu-ray because you can preview the Blu-ray and set it all up while you're getting it ready, because a Blu-ray would have a lot of ads and other menus at the start that you may not want to actually have show up. Now I've got the volume control, of course, down here. Touch that. Obviously it controls the volume on the JSD60 over there, and I've also got I can change the input if I want to go to the mic, for example. We'll go over to the mic over there. Pretty standard stuff. But also we've got all the access of the doors, lights, masking. That's a special command for the IMS. Now, nice thing about here, we've added to it, so when you hit the Blu-ray button, it actually brings up a Blu-ray control. And so, as you know, this interface can be on any web-based laptop. So you could be downstairs with your laptop and have exactly the same control as you see here. It works exactly the same. So that's very important, because if you're using the Blu-ray, obviously you can't be up here with the remote control doing the control of the Blu-ray. So you can be downstairs and also still controlling the Blu-ray as if you're up here. Very useful for a Blu-ray, very common in these regional locations or other locations who needs to run Blu-ray. So yes, that's one of the main new sort of integration parts that you see here. So we'll just quickly go over some of the equipment here. You've got the eCinema at the top. You've got a TV box here. There's the Blu-ray player there. As you can see, the switch, lots of devices behind here to make all this happen. We've got a VPN gateway server here and a UPS. You should always put your equipment on a UPS. I should do a video on that, but it's such an important, specifically an online UPS, to protect it from any power spikes or dirty power, because this equipment is very, very affected by that. Now we've typically got the sound rack over here and the sound processor and the laptop for them to run everything from, especially when they want to go downstairs and run it from downstairs. And again, we're using the good old Junior for the light controls. That'd still be plugged in actually, but it's there ready to go with the electrician. And yes, so that's the evolution of the sort of features you should get from a projection room going forward. And as I said, everything is based on the VPN, controllable from a support network. So it can be run from a remote location and or diagnosed and fixed remotely if any problems occur or any tweaking needs to happen to the automation. As you know, one final thing, in the automation, there's quite a lot of configuration to be there, especially there's the main macro automation here. So this basically sets the state of the auditorium. And for example, if you want to set the screen up or the projector up for a specific thing, you can click one button. Like if it Blu-ray, you'll see that this turns the Blu-ray. It's telling the projector to go to the right channels for Blu-ray. It's telling the sound processor to go to the right audio channel for Blu-ray, and pretty much everything's there. The Blu-ray would now be on the screen. As you can see there through the little camera, that we have an IP camera, that you can see the Blu-ray, or just the Blu-ray as well, and you can see they've got the same image there and up there at the same time. Anyway, yes, the evolution of the projection booth. I hope you enjoy my videos, and I hope everyone can get to this sort of level of integration, because it really does help a lot and makes the usability of these sophisticated installations much better for especially for regional and other locations where it's hard for them to get trained people to operate it. Anyway, bye from now from James Garden, CineTechGeek.
DCP Player Free. Get it now from digital.net.au.